Welcome to Coal Watch, our monthly series designed to provide you with insight and analysis on the global coal market, discussing key price trends, market movement, and supply-demand fundamentals. I'm James O'Connell, the Editor-in-Chief of Coal at Platts. In this edition, we're going to take a closer look at price movement over the last month, paying particular attention to Australia and China. First, though, let's have a quick update on India and how the monsoon will impact buying patterns. We spoke about Indian demand continuing throughout the monsoon season last month, and we stand by that. We saw last month that port stocks, excluding Mundra, were pretty stable for this time of the year at between 8 and 9 million tonnes. Well, they've now increased to 10.5 million tonnes as of July 15, although there has been some drawdown on thermal stocks, now standing at just over 7.5 million tonnes. But that's not the full picture, though, and it's important that we also consider utility stocks. And you can see from this slide that we're looking at quite elevated stock levels of around 20 million tonnes, traditionally quite high for this time of the year. Indian buyers are still affected by the weak rupee, and this is dampening demand. However, year-to-date imports are up by some 40%, and, as you can see by data provided by Macquarie here, are annualising out at about 139 million tonnes. And this is certainly what we're hearing and seeing as well. It's looking like a bumper year for imports, despite the prevailing winds. Breaking down the monsoon on a month-by-month basis, you can see that activity has really increased over the last number of years, and given the import figures that we've just spoken about, it looks like the trend is set to continue this year as well. Traders might want to cover their eyes right now. We have seen a significant drop in prices over the last month, and you can see here from the Newcastle 5500 price in red that it has fallen off a cliff and given up about $7 since mid-June. Our recently launched Fob Richards Bay 5500 price, seen here in mustard, has also had a turbulent month and is clinging on to $66 a tonne by its fingertips right now. The exception is Fob Kalimantan. Now, while these prices usually lag others in international indicators, and in this instance, producers are maintaining their sold forward and see no need to lower their prices, causing the bid-offer spread to widen. Deals for 5,500 NAR Indonesian prices are getting done around the $70 a tonne mark, even if the lower CV market is a bit more active. The news in China is not any better. Delivered prices have slumped since mid-June and have even fallen a couple of dollars below domestic coals, but this is still not enticing many buyers into the market. Chinese utilities are telling us that they have no concern about stock levels as there's plenty of coal in the market, and they continue to see prices falling in the short term. With increased rainfall in southwest China upping hydro levels, a slowing annualized growth rate of 7.6% in the June-ended quarter has added to the bearishness around China's demand for coal. On a more physical level, Asian producers are also contending with Russian, Colombian and even US coal being offered aggressively into the market right now. The only good news is that buyers are holding off due to the long sailing times from these locations. Finally this month, I leave you with the latest import data for China. You can see here that imports are generally stabilising just above the 8 million tonne mark and dominated as expected by Australia in red and in mustard, Indonesia of course. However, in May, as we've just noticed, we did see an increase in Russian coal, which you can see here in light blue. All the good news was for buyers this month, I'm afraid. For the latest market information, please do pick up a copy of Coal Trader International. And in the meantime, happy trading.